Hi, I'm Gareth Bowen from Roland UK, and I'm down at Nevada Music, and it's my pleasure to show you the new Roland FA-06 workstation. Quick features of it: full 16-track sequencer, full sampler, very, very easy to use, which was one of the main things. So the sequencer has been taken back to square one and redesigned, sampler very easy, very lightweight, unlike most workstations as well. From the moment I press the on switch, it only takes 7.5 seconds for the whole keyboard to be loaded up and ready to go. Everything is stored onto SD card on this keyboard, which is one of the reasons why it's very quick. So I'm going to give you a run through of what the keyboard's all about. First of all, the sounds. Our flagship sound module, the Integra, this is where all the sounds have come from. So for instance, if I was just to pick a sound and hit enter, we'd see a familiar screen that the Integra has, and it's all the sounds categorized. You have the supernatural acoustic tones of the Integra, you have the supernatural synth tones and the PCM tones, and you can take the sounds from the Integra, the synth tones, and import them into the keyboard. You can also go to the Roland Axial site and download all the Integra sounds and put those onto this keyboard as well. So we have a nice high-res screen, really easy to see, but the main thing, as I said, is how easy this keyboard is. So for instance, go to piano, electric piano, acoustic piano. See the list of the sounds, just press enter and scroll down to the rest of the pianos that are in there. On the left of this keyboard, we have our split and dual. You'll have seen these before in the Junos. So if I put split, I've got now one piano there, and if I want to put a different sound there, strings for instance, I've got split, dual, which is a layer of those two sounds. But if I hold these two together now, I have the studio set. And basically what this is, as with the Integra, 16 different sounds at a time, either split, layered, however you want to set them. It's known as combination in some keyboards as well. So 16 different sounds, and it's titled as studio sets. And there's over 512 user studio sets. So we'll be using those for the sequence, and we're also using them for layering and splitting of multiple sounds. And there's also a favorite control here, which allows you to store groups of, you know, up to 100 different favorites in an order that you prefer. Also on the left-hand side of the screen here, we would have seen sound modifiers on Roland keyboards before. This gives six different controls for the keyboard. However, this one has 4x6, so you can do the first thing, which would be cut off resonance. Then you could come down, change the EQ of a sound. Then you could assign these parts to be whatever you want them to be. And you've also got compressor, tone, and chorus. And before I move over to this side of the screen, yes, we've got the D-beam, and we have controller switches, plus controller pedals on the back. But we have this button here called door control. This is a workstation, but it's designed to be also used up with door systems. And what the door control does is it automatically assigns your computer to this keyboard, whether it be Logic Pro or Cubase or Sonar. It's not just Sonar anymore. It's the various different door systems. And this turns the tape transport of the keyboard to control the computer. You don't have to do anything apart from press that button, and it will automatically link up to your computer. So it's quite cool. So moving over to this side, which is the sequencer side, if I just pick a come to my initial studio set here and just have an acoustic piano sound, let me just scroll right back to where we were at the beginning and hit the acoustic piano, or actually electric piano I'm going to use. And the idea of this is to quickly be able to record a sequence. If you have an idea and you think, oh, I don't want to forget that, I want to record it. There is no, there's a quick way of getting around everything on this keyboard. So I can literally go straight to record on this. And all I need to do is press record, and you'll hear a metronome. You can set the tempo up either by tap tempo or any other, by turning the dial. And it has also, if I just turn it down a second, an automatic quantize, input quantize. So I'll say, yes, I'm going to quantize, and I'll come down to eighth. And then you have this loop. Now, this is a continuous loop recording, which means it allows you to keep going certain sections of a song, or you can turn it off. It's up to you. So let's just stick with that for a second, and you'll see it's already on this sound. So, and then I can hit record, get one bar intro. Even out of time there to push me back in. I could then just go to my sequencer page, and you'll see all 16 instruments. As with the Integra, every single instrument on the keyboard has its own multi-effects. So there's 67 to choose from for every single sound. And you can just go straight back in, and I can go to another sound, just scrolling down my sounds, pick a different sound, organ, or anything I want, straight in, and add another sound. And it'll loop that. And you can press, while it's recording, you could just hit the record button and allow it to come out of record but stay in that control. Also, while you're in the sequencer mode, you've got a full mixer. So you can come onto the mixer, and there's separate chorus, reverbs, pan control, and EQ running out of the master. Now, what I'm going to do now, I'm going to load a song that I've already prepared on it, just to show you what we're coming over to the sampling side. There is also here a full rhythm player, which is really cool because it allows you to use the presets from the keyboard within the songs and over all the different kits. And you have all the Supernatural acoustic kits, PCM kits, so we'll have all the old 808, 909 kits in there as well, plus variations, plus the ability to do step control. But as I said before, I'm going to load a song now, which I've used one of those loops in. So all I need to do is come back to my song player. I've called this 80s song, just because a lot of the sounds, you've got all the old classic Roland sounds on here, which so it gives it that sort of 80s sound. And if I press play, you'll hear a little bit of it. And I can come over to the mixer again, just to see the mix. And while it's going, come out of the mix page. Now, the thing is, if I'm a DJ or I'm using a keyboard live for a sampler, I want to be able to trigger off certain parts of that, whether it be just the keyboard and a hi-hat or separate things. And the other thing is, even though those sounds have their own multi-effects, the keyboard has a new thing completely, which is called total effects, TFX. And what that is, if I hold the menu button down until come down to effects edit, TFX works with, so you have all your individual multi-effects on every single keyboard, and then the TFX runs over the complete keyboard. Now, this is really cool for when you are using the sample pad and you want to add different effects to different samples. So if I press the TFX button, another effects screen comes up, so I can still play the track. But now I can come through these effects, and they're specially designed effects as well that are good for DJs. So if I come onto the looper, and I can play around with these effects. Come to a different one. Beat looper is quite cool as well. Big crash. So the way to use this now within the sequencer, it's a 16 track sequencer, a MIDI sequencer. But if I wanted to use this for audio, I can do it two ways. I can put a microphone in the back. I've got separate effects for the microphone as well. I could put a microphone in the back. I could put a guitar in the back. Or I can sample directly to the keyboard. Now, these pads are multifunctional. So I can use them as a numeric pad to dial up sounds. I could use them for editing tones. Remember, it's got the same editing, but a much easier way of getting around it. Same editing as the Integra. So I could use it for dialing up partials. And there's also other pages for software updates if people recommend or we need to use these pads. This works really well with main stage as well, because I've had to use it on main stage. And I thought, oh, that's quite cool. So basically now what you do is just come to sampler, pick a pad that you want to sample. So I'm going to say pad 16. It'll tell me there's a sample already on there, but I can overwrite that. Remember, this goes straight down to SD card as well, so it's very quick. So it's telling me, what do I want to sample? The keyboard itself and an input, or you can switch it to just keyboard or just input. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to sample a bit of my sequence. I'm going to turn auto trigger on, so as soon as I press play, it starts sampling. Press stop when I've finished. Now the screen will now change, and you can see that you've got full editing of that sample, truncating, looping, and it's over here. Exactly the same quality and level that it went in at. Now those effects that I showed, the TFX effects, are really quite cool, because what you could do is sample it with those effects on, as I have here. That was the wah-wah. That's a splicer. And then I've broken it down. So if I wanted to, every single song has 16 samples times four. So there's four banks of 16 samples for every single song. Your memory is only restricted to what, how big an SD card it comes. And it comes with a 4 gig anyway. So now I can trigger the samples as I've broken them down. If I press the hold button, it'll hold it. I can come out of this page completely while it's in there. Press hold, and now I can take the sequencer off. I can come in and I can actually build up, play over the top with a full 16 part combination if I want to. And then you can build up more. So remember, there's four at a time you can do. Way of getting around, move around the keyboard now. Now, being this is a 16-part multi-timbral sequencer, MIDI sequencer, all I need to do now is, if I want to, I can either sample my BV straight into the keyboard, resequence the pads, or using the DAW system, come straight, do all my backing vocals, and then have those on here. So this kind of turns it into an audio recorder as well then, because I can use four banks of 16 samples for every single song. It's so easy to get around this keyboard. The sequencer side of it is the main complete difference as far as structuring, as far as how to actually program. On the back of the keyboard, we've got a stereo left and right output, but we've also got a sub output. And this for live work is also really important, because it sends a click. So if a drummer is sitting in the band and you're using the workstation as a workstation live, it means that he can have a separate click, or you can route a bass through it as well. You've also got multiple controls with the pedals, so you can assign two pedals here. You can also assign the switches, and you can assign all of these knobs. And as I said before, using this with main stage, I can use this to read and learn, which is the software I tend to use live quite a lot. And it's a really good way of going through it. You've also got other functions here. So when it's on pad utility, that's where you can tell what the pads are going to do. You can come through the different things and say part select or numerical. But also, I can use a clipboard. So I can take samples from one song, clipboard it, and put that onto another song. So I can have different banks set up every single time that I'm doing this. It's so easy to use. And just to emphasize the point of how quick it is to load up, if I just switch this off, you won't get any other workstation that works like this. It's so quick. It's 7.5 seconds, but not only has it loaded all the sounds within that 7.5 seconds, it's also loaded the sequence and all the different samples at the same time for each song. And then if you wanted to load another song, also the speed is ridiculously quick. You can just come straight through, click on load, are you sure, click OK, and then there's another song loaded into the track as well. And then it's just a matter of pressing play. So we've got incredible effects, every single sound having its own individual effect. Separate effects for microphone coming in. Total effects, which is a new thing that Roland just designed, where you have an overall multi-effects running over the entire keyboard as well. Separate compression, separate EQ, pan control, full workstation, full sampler, 16 sounds at a time. 16, the supernatural synth tones can run up to 3 oscillators. You could run all 16 instruments and have every oscillator split across the keyboard as well. It's a completely new technology. We love it. And we're going to show you that you're going to love it as well, because this is going to come in at under £850. Now, as I said before, there's the FA-08 as well, which is exactly the same brains, but it's with a full 88-note keyboard, weighted keyboard, and that's going to come in at under £1,300. So thank you, Nevada. Hope you like it as much as I do, and hope to see you soon. Okay, let me run through what we've got on the back of the keyboard. So we've got stereo headphones, we've got left and right output, but we've also got the sub out, which is really important for the click, bass, etc. We've got a stereo line input for sampling. We've also got a switch then for guitar or mic input plus level, so you can switch between the two. Two different controller pedals and a hole pedal, but the hole pedal can also be assigned to be whatever you want. Then you have your MIDI sockets. You have two USBs. One is for update, software update. The other one is for door control and, you know, syncing it up to your door. Remember, you've got the driver, audio driver and USB driver built into it. And then underneath this protective plate is the SD card. This is just so you don't lose it or get it nicked. So you can take that out and keep replacing the SD cards. Not forgetting the weight of this keyboard, the whole idea is also to make this very portable. We're only talking 5.7 kilos, so it's a very, very light instrument to carry, and yet it's very sturdy. The market for this keyboard is kind of titled, not just for performance, but for studio as well, but also for the DJs out there that want something that they can trigger, but also play along to. You know, so they've got the sounds here already, plus the drum loops. So we are kind of looking like a general keyboard here for performancing, for all age groups for performance. And then with the sample and workstation, the creative side of it, you're sort of covering pretty much everybody with it. We'll be right back.